So dear students, welcome once again to the class of topology. We will continue in continuation of the previous lecture in which we proved some theorems related to connectedness in topology. The next theorem here is, let E be a connected subset of a space X if F is a subset of X such that E is a subset of F and F is a subset of E bar, then F is connected. In particular, we can say that E bar is connected. Now, how to prove it? The proof is really very easy. Here, we are given that E is connected. We are given that E is a connected set. Now, F is a subset of X. F is a subset of X such that E is a subset of F and F is a subset of E bar. What we have to prove that F is connected. Once again, we will prove this theorem by the method of contradiction. So we suppose if possible, F is disconnected.
And we know that if A is a subset of B, then their intersection is equal to the
smaller of the two sets, that means B. So it is another result with us. Now, E bar intersection B is equal to B. And E bar intersection B is also equal to Y. From these two results, we can directly say that B is equal to Y, which is a contradiction, because earlier we said that A and B are non-empty sets. Here B comes to be Y. That means we arrive at a contradiction. And this contradiction is because our supposition was wrong. And what our supposition was? Our supposition was that F is disconnected. And since we arrive at a contradiction, that means our supposition is wrong. That means F must be a connected set. So it is the proof of the first term. Now we move. So for the proof, we will move to the method of contradiction. Suppose, if possible, E is disconnected. Now E is disconnected, that means there exists non-empty sets A and B, proper subsets of X, such that their union is E, A bar intersection B is Y, and A intersection B bar is also Y. Now A union B is E. A is non-empty, B is non-empty. Since A and B are non-empty sets, therefore there exists some element small a in A, and there exists some element B in B. As the hypothesis is given to us that every two points of E are contained in some connected subset of E. So A and B must also be connected, contained in some connected subset of E. So let that subset be F. So there exists a connected subset F of E such that A and B both are in contained in F. And F is a subset of E. F is a subset of E. E means a union B. E is a union B. That means A and B are contained in F, and F is a subset of A union B. F is a subset of a disconnection of A and B. By previous term, F is completely contained in A, or F is completely contained in B. Without loss of generality, we suppose that F is completely contained in A. That means A and B are in F, and F is a subset of A. This means A and B are both contained in A. Now, look at this. B is contained in A. B is also contained in B. That means B is a point of A as well as a point of B, which shows that A intersection B is not Y, which is a contradiction, because A and B are separated sets, and every two separated sets are disjoint. That means A and B must be disjoint, and here we have a contradiction, because A and B, their intersection is coming to be non-empty. And this contradiction is because our supposition was wrong. That means what we have supposed, that E is disconnected, is not correct. That means E must be a connected set, and that is the proof of the second theorem. Now, we move on to the third theorem, written on the right side of the board. Look at the statement in the third theorem. In the third theorem, we are given that there is a family C alpha of connected subsets of the space X. Here, C alpha, where alpha belonging to lambda, is a family of connected subsets of the topological space X top. And with the property that they are having non-empty intersection, we are shown that their union is connected. Once again, we will move by using the method of contradiction. Suppose if possible. Suppose if possible, union C alpha, where alpha belongs to lambda, be disconnected. Suppose it is a disconnected set. Now, since it is a disconnected set, so there exists non-empty proper subsets A and B of X, both open, such that their union is equal to union of C alpha alpha belonging to lambda, and their intersection is phi. The intersection of A and B is phi. Union of A and B is union of C alpha, where alpha belongs to lambda. For every alpha belonging to lambda, note that A intersection with C alpha, union A, B intersection with C alpha. What it is? By using the law of distributivity, it is A union B intersection with C alpha. Now A union B is the union of all C alphas, and the union of all C alpha intersected with a particular C alpha is equal to C alpha. So this is equal to C alpha. The union of these two sets is coming out to be C alpha. And note that since A and B, these are two disjoint sets, A intersection C alpha and B intersection C alpha, being the subsets of two disjoint sets, they are automatically disjoint. Now, C alpha is expressed as union of two disjoint open subsets of C alpha. That means C alpha is disconnected, which is not the case, because we are given that all the C alphas are connected. That means something is wrong, and that means one of these two must be empty. If both are not empty, then C alpha must be disconnected. So without loss of generality, we can take one of these two as an empty set. We suppose that A intersection C alpha is empty. Now, using this result over this result here, in this result, if we use A intersection C alpha to be empty, empty set union with this set is equal to C alpha, which means B intersection with C alpha is C alpha. And as we have discussed earlier, the intersection of two sets is one of the two sets, means the resultant set is the smaller of the two sets. So this means C alpha is a subset of B for every alpha belonging to the particular family lambda. Now every alpha, C alpha, is a subset of B, means their union is also a subset of B. Now union of C alpha is a subset of B, but union of C alpha, we have seen that it is equal to A union B. So this means A union B is a subset of B. A union B is a subset of B, means A is phi. This clearly implies A is empty set, and this is a contradiction, because A and B are both non-empty sets. So we arrive at a contradiction. And this contradiction is because our supposition was wrong, and our supposition was wrong because supposition was union of C alpha alpha belonging to lambda is disconnected. That means it must be a connected set. So it is the proof of the third term here. And now we move on to the last term of this lecture. In the last term, we looked at the statement is very much similar to the statement of the third term. The only thing here given that C alpha, alpha belonging to lambda, is a family of connected subsets of space X, such that one of the members of this family intersects every other. Earlier, every two members were intersecting, and now a particular member of this family is intersecting with all the other members of this family. Let that number be named as C alpha naught. So C alpha naught is a member of this family which intersects with every other member of the family. Now consider the rest of the members as C alpha 1, C alpha 2, C alpha 3, and so on. C alpha naught is a member such that C alpha naught intersection with C alpha I is non-empty for every I. Or we can say that C alpha naught intersection with C alpha is not empty for every alpha belonging to that particular family lambda for which we are talking about. Now we name C alpha naught union with C alpha as the set D alpha. We are having another family D alpha, alpha belonging to lambda. The members of this family are now C alpha naught union C alpha 1, C alpha naught union C alpha 2, C alpha naught union C alpha 3, and so on. What the special thing about this family is that this is also a family of connected sets. Why? Because D alpha is union of two connected sets such that their intersection is non-empty. By the previous term, we know that if intersection of two connected sets is non-empty, then their union is also connected. That means this set is connected because these two sets are connected and their intersection is non-empty. So D alpha is connected. That means D alpha is connected for every alpha belonging to lambda. Now look at, if we take any two members of this family, suppose D alpha I and D alpha j, what is their intersection? D alpha I is C alpha naught union with C alpha I, and intersection with C alpha naught union C alpha j. By using the distributive property of set theory, we can write it as C alpha naught intersection with C alpha I union C alpha j. Look at C alpha naught is common in these two sets. C alpha naught is here and C alpha naught is also here. C alpha naught is contained in this set. C alpha naught is also contained in this set. And when C alpha naught is contained in both these sets, then intersection of these two cannot be pi. So this intersection is non-empty. That means D alpha is a family of connected sets such that every two members of D alpha are now intersecting each other. By the third term, where the same statement was given, we were having that union of C alpha is connected. So here what we will have? We will have that union of D alpha. We will have union of D alpha. Alpha belonging to lambda is connected. Union of D alpha. Alpha belonging to lambda is connected. But our requirement is the union of C alpha, where alpha belonging to lambda is connected. Look at, if we substitute the value of D alpha, what we get from here? Union of C alpha naught union with C alpha, alpha belonging to lambda is connected. Is connected. Now, we can take C alpha naught out. So we can write it as C alpha naught union with union of C alpha, alpha belonging to lambda is connected. One of the members of the family of C alpha is there, the rest of the members are here. So that means what we are having here, we are having here the union of all the members of the family C alpha. So what it becomes? It becomes union of C alpha, alpha belonging to lambda. Here alpha is equal to alpha naught, was not permitted, but being C alpha naught separately here, we will get the union completely here. So this is connected, and this was what our requirement in the theorem. So that means family intersects every other member of the family, then the union is also connected